Hello, welcome to the session Tower of Honai using recursion. At the end of this session, the student will be able to implement Tower of Honai program using recursion in C. Now see the pictures. Do you know what the pictures are about? Okay, these are the pictures of Tower of Honai. We will see what is the Tower of Honai. Now, in the Tower of Honai, we are having 1, 2, 3, 4 discs like this. There may be any number of discs. Then we are having 3 towers, A, B, C. The towers are fixed, only 3 towers are there, but disc may be vary in the numbers. So after that, what we have to do, we have to transfer the disc from source to the destination. In this way, while sending from source to destination, the B is the auxiliary, temporary or intermediate tower. Here we can see A is the source tower from where the disc has to be moved. B is the auxiliary tower. Temporary, we have to take the support of that. And C is the destination tower. Now, for this, we are having some rules that the disc can be vary in their number, but we are having only 3 towers. And we have to transfer the disc from one tower to the another tower. Here, one more condition is that only one disc can be moved at a time. And you can place a bigger disc over a smaller disc. So this is wrong way. Now when we are having a single disc, that time we can directly move one disc to the destination disk. If we are having two, then we are having first we have to move first one into the auxiliary, then second one we can move to the final, and then first one can be put on that top of the second. So first, second and third, 3 steps are required in the two disk. When the disk is more, the complications are more. So for that, we have to go for some algorithm. So in this case, we are having 3 discs. So first we have moved to the C, then we can move second to the B. First we have moved to the C, then second to the B. Then the first disc can be from C to B on the top of the second disc. Then third can be moved to the C. By rule, we are doing everything. So here you can see, this is the condition. Next, we have moved the nth disc to the destination. Now, remaining n minus 1, all the disc we have to move to the final destination. For that, again, we have to recursively do the thing. That is, here 1 is moved to the A. Then 2 is moved to the C, and again finally we have put 1 to the C. So these steps has to be followed. Now one algorithm here we can fix out, that is, if we are having ABC rods or tower or pegs, then N are the total number of the discs. Here we can move n minus 1, in this case 3 disc, we are having 2 disc move from A to B using auxiliary tower. Then transfer the disc, that is the final largest disc 3, from A to C. Then remaining all the disc we have to move from B to C using this A auxiliary tower. Now this is the program for the Tower of Honai program. That is, we are having function, that is tower function. Here we are number of disk, then tower names are there. They are in the characters. In this case, we will ask user how many disks are there, and accordingly we are calling the function by sending this A, B and C. So here A is source and C is the destination, and C, B will be the auxiliary or temporary disk. Now here you can see the program, we are sending A, B, C. Here we are calling function ACB first, and then the first ABC will call first ACB and then BAC. Okay. Now we will see how the moves are there. ABC will call ACB and BAC. Again ACB will call, it is considering ABC. Again it will be recursively call this function. You can see here B has shifted to the last and B has shifted to the first. Here the middle C is shifted to the last and C middle shifted to the first place. In this recursive call you can see that is the center part A has shifted to the last and center part A has shifted to the one. So this ABC, the places are changed, but it is considered as ABC and accordingly the moves are going to be done. And finally, after this recursive calls with this, we are getting the all the steps in the sequence. First step, it will be you move A to C first, then A to B, then C to B, then A to C, then B to A, then B to C, and then A to C. Okay. So this is the sequence finally we are getting with this all call. We can see or we can match it if it is working or not. Now this is our sequence. Now we will see ABC is calling this one and this ACB is calling ABC. Now how our work will be there? Now first case, A is shifting to the C. A is shifting to the C. So this is the first step. This is the correct. Next, we are calling this A to B. Okay. We are moving A to B. This is also correct one. Then we are calling C to B. Whatever the C was there, it is moving to the B. So here it is a C is moving to the B. That is the first disk. Then next, in the sequence, it will be recursively come here after completion of this. Here it will call whatever the A was there, disk, that is moving to the C. Then next, in this position, again, freshly it will call for moving this N minus 1 disk to the destination or C. So for that, again, now next, we are having call this, that is a B is moving to A. So B is moving to A. What was the B? B is here A. This disk is moving to the A. So after that, we have to shift this B tower disk to the C. B tower to the C. So it will move to the last one. And then finally, we have to move. This is the A tower first disk to the last tower. So it is moving correctly whatever the recursion call are there. So accordingly, the tower of Hanai works. Thank you.